But can I talk to you about sure. what the yeah, so what's this event about? Can I interview you?
This song?
Yeah. Well, this just says why are we here? What's going on?
Oh, today is the closure of the it's a celebration for the people who have gone across the country, saying that they don't have documents and they are not fearful.
Okay.
Saying that they are coming out of the shadows and confront and overcome their fears, but also overcome the adversaries. People that believe that migrants shouldn't be here, people that believe that migrants aren't part of our society, of our economy, of our culture. Those people, without papers and without fear, defy sheriff, they defy police departments throughout the South. They defy racism in their journey.
Mm-hmm.
And it's taken 6 weeks for them to come here to Charlotte to tell President Obama that he has to stop the deportation.
Mm-hmm.
To tell him that there's another way of doing business. That his legacy so far is that of the president that has deported most people in the history of our country. He has an opportunity to come clean in the second term. He has an opportunity for us, for Latinos, for immigrants, for people of color, for anybody who believes in justice. He has an opportunity to come clean and say, I was the president that was there for migrants. I was the president that I was there for working people. I was the president that was there for civil rights. He has that opportunity right now because we know that the other folks in Florida, the Republicans, we know that they have gone completely crazy. They have become a fascist party. They have become an anti-Latino party. They have become an anti-working people party. They have become a racist party. You couldn't even believe some of the things that came out of the mouth of many participants in that convention. We know that those folks aren't with us. So this president has an opportunity, and that's why the writers are here to remind him that he has to do the right thing.
And how many people came on the bus?
I would say it was about 50 people.
50? Wow. How far did they come?
Started in Arizona, Phoenix, Arizona, the 30th.
The 30th? Yeah. All right. And what's the plan for the rest of the convention? Are they going to do any more events? Or?
Yes. Tomorrow they have some activities planned.
Hmm?
So, yeah, and I think it goes all the way to 7.
Alright. And can I get your name?
My name is Pablo Alvarado.
Okay. And is there anything you want people to know that you think is important to give to somebody who's listening?
Well, it's important for people to... The reason why the writers said I'm going to overcome the fear, the reason why they did it, they risked everything, okay?
Mm-hmm.
They risked being deported, they risked being without their families, I mean, they risked everything. And the reason why they did it is because they want Americans to see them as who they are. As fathers, mothers, daughters, sons, grandkids. In the bus you have people who are young and people who are older, mothers and sons. So they want essentially people to see them as they are, human beings. So I ask our adversaries and our friends to change their idea about migrants.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you for having me here. All right, so I'm going to go down. I just want to quickly catch the stuff real quick. This is a docu-bus event to commemorate their journey here to the DNC to tell Obama that he's right now the legacy he's leaving is the legacy of the president who did the most deportations during his time. And these folks would like to change that. They feel as General was saying that there's really no other option. The other side is, as you can see, it's like you needed their fascist party, an anti-Latino party, according to this gentleman. And this is the opportunity for this president to come forth and claim migrants to be who they are, and that is to be humans. And the people on the Adaki bus, because there's 50 people who have risked everything to be here. They have not hidden their undocumented. They could be deported at any time. and they can lose their connection to their families. All right, that's it, though. I'm going to go down. Pamela Davids, thanks. Bye.